Hello guys, welcome back to the Class 4 Orals TGS Marine YouTube channel. Today, we are going to discuss about what are the equipments given in a lifeboat. As per the SOLAS regulation, we have to know what are the lifeboat equipments. In this video, we are taking the case of a free-fall lifeboat, and the equipment list which we are going to discuss is complying with the latest SOLAS regulations. So let's quickly discuss one by one. What are the items given along with the sketch and their real photographs and the number of quantity and the location of their storage. So first one is the boat hook. The boat hook are given in 2 in number and they are secured in the boat. Second, the bind baler. The bind baler is a kind of cup with a handle. It is given 1 in number and it is placed in the equipment tank in the boat. Third, the bucket. The buckets are given 2 and they are placed in the boat. Fourth, the important, the survival manual. The survival manual is given 1 in number and it is placed in the equipment tank in the boat. Fifth, next to the steering position, there is a compass and it is mounted in the boat at the steering position. Sixth, sea anchor. The sea anchor is completely given with a tripping line, and you can see in the diagram and the real-time photograph, it is placed in the boat in a wrapped manner. Seventh, painter. The painter length is twice the stowage height and it is minimum 50 meters, and the painters are given 2 in numbers. Eighth, hatchet. The hatchets are like axe or the cutter. They are provided one at each end of the boat and they are secured in the boat. Ninth, rust proof dipper with lanyard, and it is placed in the equipment tank in boat, one quantity. Tenth, water in 1/2 liter per bag. So for per person, 3 liters of water is there and it is stored in a GRP water tank in the boat. GRP is glass reinforced plastic, and for your information, GRP is also the material for the body of lifeboat and rescue boat, and this is glass reinforced plastic. 11th, rust proof graduated drinking vessel. This is like a glass, like we are having a normal glass, plastic glass. It is given 1 in number. 12th, the food ration. The important value for the ration is it is approximately giving 10,000 kilojoules of the energy per person. Like for the ration, it's kind of a biscuit or it could be any eatable, and it has to give the energy at least 10,000 kilojoules per person, and it is placed in a watertight tank in the boat. 13th, the most important, rocket parachute flares. They are given 4 in number, and they are in the screw top watertight box placed in the equipment tank in the boat. Next, hand flares. The hand flares are 6, and it is like stored in a screw top watertight box placed in the equipment tank in the boat again. 15th, the bind smoke signals. They are 2 in numbers, again in the same place. Please do not get confused in the rocket parachute flares and hand flares quantity. The rocket parachute flares are 4 in number and the hand flares are 6 in number. 16th, the waterproof electric signaling torch with 1 piece of spare bulb and 2 piece of spare batteries. You can see here, this is the waterproof electric torch. 1 piece of spare bulb for fitting inside the torch and 2 spare batteries. Here also in the real photograph you can see, and it is given 1 in number. 17th, the daylight signaling mirror with instructions. It is 1. 18th, the copy of life saving signals on waterproof card. This is the waterproof card, and life-saving signals are mentioned in this paper. 19th, whistle. The whistle is very much important, and it has got its importance in case of rescuing and in case of any kind of emergency. So it is given one. Next, the first aid kit in a waterproof case. This is the first aid kit, and the identity of the first aid kit, as you all know, is a cross mark, and it is given one box. 21 number is anti seasickness tablets. So the anti seasickness tablets are at least for 48 per person, and it is placed in the first aid kit. This is the seasickness bag for like vomiting of, or someone is getting uneasy. So for that, for each person, one packet is there, one bag is there. 23rd, the jackknife with lanyard. This is the jackknife, like sharp knife with a like all we know with a nail cutter, like cutter, and it is given with a lanyard. It is given one. Next, can opener, again for opening any kind of tumbler or whatever. This is given three numbers. Next, the bind rescue kit with 30 meter bind line. This is the bind rescue kit. Do not get confused between the your Lifebuoy and bind rescue kit. This is kind of like it can be easily coiled, and it comes out of the packet in the form of a rescue kit, and they are given two in number. Next, the manual pump in case of filling of water in the bilges or like any accumulation of water in the lifeboat, we can manually pump out, and it is mounted in the boat. This is one. A set of fishing tackle is also given, one in number, for fishing and for survival. It is given one quantity. 28th, the most important, a portable fire extinguisher, which is given one. 29th, the searchlight. The searchlight is usually given next to the steering wheel. 30th, the radar reflector. The radar reflector is placed in the equipment box, equipment tank in the boat, or fixed. So this is given, and it reflects the radar, and it helps in like early rescuing. 31, thermal protected aids, TPA. This is a TPA, thermal protected aid, and it is not less than 10% of the persons, and it should be minimum 2. So suppose there are 20 people, then it should not be less than 2. It is placed in the equipment tag in the boat. Next is the 2x5 liter capacity container, and 1 unit of flexible hose for collecting rainwater. So for collecting the rainwater, this is a container for having drinking. And please remember, in case of rain, do not drink the first rain water. After second rain water, you can have it. And next one is the rope ladder, and the rope ladder is like given, and it is very much useful in case of rescuing person or drowning person. So you can make it fall from the lifeboat, and person can climb up, and you can rescue them. So this is how all these lists are given for a free-fall lifeboat. As per the ship and different lifeboats, and like there can be free-fall or davit launch. So more or less the items are almost same. It may vary somewhere, but these list is very much important. And in orals, the surveyor usually asks about how many number of rocket parachute flares and hand flares and bind smoke signals, and along with what are the ration quantity, like how many kilojoules of energy each ration is having. So all these points need to be remembered, and I hope this video is very much helpful, and you can have a quick reference for answering in the MMD orals. And please do subscribe to the channel and share this channel to the maximum people for effective help, and take care.